think of to to get yourself.
I'll spin the bag like this. A lot of people hold it like this and they'll kind of flap it.
Uh-huh.
So my way of spinning it, and that's a lot of people that are throwing it like that way now, is that the bag is going through the air flatter.
Sure.
And it's going to hit and it slides it. This way, when it flops on there, you don't know which way it's going to go, right or left or whatever. So
you're kind of taking a gamble with that.
Yeah, so there's a lot of people that are going to the spinning style.
Okay. And you mentioned there's some new bags that have a grippy side and
a
slippery side.
Yeah, stop and go bag.
Uh-huh.
One side of the bag is like a duck cloth, and the other side is like a grippy side. And a lot of times you want to throw that grippy. If you go first, you want to throw that grippy side first. If it stops before the hole, it's like a park, like blocking the hole, and that your opponent will either have to carry that one in or go over the top.
Okay.
Usually 90% of the time they'll try to carry it in. And then you just go do the same thing.
Sure.
Try to throw that grippy side in. But then if he has one on and the hole's open and try to throw the slippery side, they go in the hole.
Now, when you aim for the hole, are you aiming right for the hole, or do you aim for kind of a bigger target like they do in golf?
I aim just in front of the hole if I can, let it slide in.
Uh-huh.
So that's a lot of times if you have a wall all built up with bags, or you got to try to airmail, that's what they call it, airmail go over the top.
Okay, sure. All right, well, thanks a lot.
You bet.